This is Deb from Therapy Life, bringing you the latest feeds in electronic and underground music. Our guest today is one of the most respected names in the industry. Brought to you by Therapy Sessions, here's Steve Lawler.
Hi, how are you doing?
It's great to have you, Steve. To begin this session, we'd like to talk more about the electronic music world, which has completely reinvented the way we approach sound. What effect do you think this change has brought upon the music that you produce?
Well, yeah, I mean, you know, the answer is yes to both. It's changed dramatically since I started making records. And yes, people's sound does change due to the technology that changes. I mean, I'll give you an example. My studio 20 years ago would cost £200,000 worth of equipment, and being that it was properly vetted for sound, and that's how you made it when you recorded to tape. Now, people can make a record on their laptop using a pair of headphones sitting in their living room, which will cost them a total of £2,000. So the difference is actually quite dramatic. But I mean, to be honest with you, the fact that technology has gotten so clever and it's made it so easy to make music, there's two sides to that coin. The one side is, yeah, there is some amazing music being made now. But the other side of it is there is an awful amount of bad music being made. Now everybody thinks they can make a record.
The type of music you play is very much considered underground, and it's got these traces of deep and dark techno. Why did you consider playing at a festival like Identity, where most of the artists are playing mainstream music?
Well, I mean, to be honest with you, the reason why I did this festival was to open myself up to a younger audience, and to be an audience that isn't really tuned into house and techno. And, you know, the way that I fuse commercial music, which the Identity opinion was majority a commercial music festival, commercial dance music, electro, dubstep, the sort of music that is very commercial and in the charts, and which had taken over America, that was the sound of Identity. And I really stood out because my music was house and techno, underground house and techno. But the reason why I did this festival was to put myself in front of an audience that might go to see Nero, you know, with Depp, or go to see, you know, I don't know, Skrillex with the more commercial, you know, happy hardcore sort of thing that he does. At the end of the day, you know, I'm not changing my sound no matter where I play. I love what I do. But I think it's really important to sort of push this sound, the underground sound. And that was my duty at this festival, is to, you know, I was singled out. I was on my own doing this. But, you know, at the end of it, I definitely had people in front of me. Maybe 2,000 people knew who I was and wanted to hear my music. And 2,000 people had never heard me before and was really quite surprised. And if that happened, then my job was done, you know. So that was my reason, really.
You mentioned sharing your music with the audiences at Identity and opening yourself up to that sort of crowd. How big of a difference was it playing for a crowd in Identity rather than your regulars at the UK or Ibiza, for example?
Yeah, there's a big difference. I mean, for example, you know, pretty much all already finding an event which is Germany, you know, that space is going to be filled with my fans, and obviously people that get deep down into some dirty, deep underground house and techno, and that's kind of a party vibe. Whereas at Identity, a lot of the time, you know, it was almost like the dubstep kids know how to dance to techno, so they just watch me. I did get a lot of that. A lot of people just sort of like nodding their head of approval as if like, I like this. I think they knew exactly what to do. No, I mean, it's good. If I can introduce a new sound to somebody and they like it, then I'm really happy with that was my job at this festival, you know. That was what I was there for, was to try and bring this sound into the festival and try and make it work, because I know that the organisers of the festival had the options of many and house and techno DJs, but they wanted somebody that would cross it over to the masses, I guess. That was the job there, you know.
I know you have quite the busy schedule and probably didn't have much time, but did you have a chance to catch any live sets at Identity?
Well, actually, I did. The only one person that I actually caught, which was briefly because he was usually playing before me, was, I know Nero is actually a duo act, but the one of them wasn't there. He was at home or whatever, I don't know, but the one act, one of the guys was playing, and they were usually on before me on the main stage. and, you know, a bit of what he did. And I must admit, the sort of earlier part of his set, I did actually really enjoy, because it reminded me of the dubstep came from London, that sort of deeper, darker, more sort of integral bass-heavy dubstep. But then towards the end of his set, he would go into the more commercial, poppy vocals and stuff, which I don't particularly... It's not really my bag. I don't really like anything that's kind of got a commercial sound to it. But the earlier stuff, I was very impressed with. But that was the only guy I really got a chance to catch.
Steering away from identity for just a second, you've put out some great productions in the past. Sleepwalking, Violet, Lost, the list goes on. Are you currently working on anything our listeners should be on the lookout for?
I did an EP with one of the artists off my label. The artist is called Detlef, and the EP, there are four tracks on there. There's a low single, which will be coming out before the end of the year. It's called Upside Down. After that, I hope I don't release anything into my album, because really my main sort of concentration after I've released these two next singles is my album.
Now, every artist has that one track he can drop at any moment and any setting and get a great response no matter what crowd he's playing for. Which track would that be for you?
Well, yeah, my latest remix. There's a single called Create Balance by Shami Abba, and it's my remix. It's been one of the biggest records in Ibiza. It sounds really stupid. I actually find it sounding very stupid when I talk about my own music that way, but it actually genuinely is. Because every single club I ever passed or go into, and local bars, played it twice in 1 hour. You know, it's a big record over here. And it's not a big record in, you know, it's, when I wrote the record, I wanted it to be big for big rooms, and, you know, it seems to have done quite well for the summer, because obviously summer is festival and Ibiza season, where there's a lot of big rooms, so you should get the right kind.
Now, to conclude this session, I'm sure our listeners would love to know your whereabouts and your plans for the evening.
Well, it's 7 o'clock in the evening here in Ibiza, and I've just come from the beach. I'm going to have some dinner in an hour or so and just chill out. You know, it's, I live in Ibiza all year round now. I love this island. It's my spiritual home. It was always my second home, but now it's my first home, because it's always been my spiritual home, and as a result, I'm a much more relaxed and happier person here.
Thanks for taking the time to talk to us, Steve. A big shout out to the Viva family that made the session possible. We all anticipate your new single and hope to have you back soon at Therapy Sessions.